Hi! The time has come to talk about my favorite editing tool of all time in Blender. So this whole video is about one tool. And the reason of this video is of course that I currently have here in YouTube so many people in one specific video asking me of how did you do these mountains? So now I will tell to everyone at the same time how I did those hacking mountains. And the tool is of course proportional editing tool. And you activate it from here. Look closely to mouse now. There are settings this and I select this time this enable one. And now when it's activated, I can with G key grab things and move around with mouse. And with mouse wheel I can change the brush size at the same time. Very cool. I'm using this one almost everything I do in Blender. You can also with this rotate things like this one, and you can also scale things like that. Everything happens so cool and smoothly. I love working with this. But that was not the whole beauty of this tool. There is even more to be played with. So next to the proportional editing menu, there is this proportional editing falloff menu. Currently I'm using this smooth falloff or brush, how I call those things. And now I'm selecting this random falloff. So now I have this random falloff enabled and ta-da! I created mountains in just 1 second. It's that easy. Can't be more easy, I think. You know, just few clicks there and there and you have this landscape from nothing. It's ridiculous easy to work with proportional editing. Okay, so what else we have here in this menu? Of course, the constant falloff. I wanna create that circular area to be a meteor crater, and I think constant falloff is the perfect tool for that little project. And this is it, the crater. So I just made this beauty. Okay, I can't say this a beautiful landscape, but it was a nice demonstration of how you create a low poly landscape in Blender in few minutes with proportional editing. Remember that. And then there is another thing with proportional editing. We have here this creature, Ed. Ed is an octopus from Mars. So the problem with Ed is that I need to move his tentacles, but I've not rigged Ed. So look at this mess. It's so dense. It's super dense, I think. So if I have to move these tentacles by one vertex at a time, I will probably shoot myself with that knife I made in previous with. Okay, no, I will never shoot anyone with knife, with anything actually. What am I talking about? So, if I select this smooth falloff and try to move only one vertex, only one tentacle at a time, you will see the problem. And the problem is bad. Even if I made the brush size smaller, the other tentacles are still following the brush. So what do you do in this situation? Now the brush is too small, by the way, so it's hard to work with that size. You of course select from this proportional editing menu this connected option. And now, woohoo, everything has changed to better. I can now move one tentacle at a time. The fallow is following the mesh structure and never moves anything that is not connected with each other inside the brass fallow. Very nice. There is of course also limitations with this tool. For example, if I have some not connected things in the same mesh and I'm using the connected brass, of course it doesn't move those eyes, cause they has to be connected physically to the head of this octopus. So this time you has to use the enable option in the proportional menu, and now the eyes are also following the brass. You can also solve this problem by physically connecting them to the mesh with one edge that will not render, and then you can use the connected brass again. Have fun! And poor Ed, he has had a very hard day. So that was the proportional editing, my favorite tool in Blender, and see you next time. Bye bye.